this video, I'm gonna show you my productivity workflow. I'm gonna be using RemNote, which is a free app that you can find here. Definitely recommend you open up a second browser and kind of follow along. If you're unfamiliar with the idea of smart notes, you can always start with this playlist here. The timestamps for this video are in the description below. Let's get started. One of the big reasons why RemNote keeps me so productive is the daily document. The reason why is because I don't need to waste my time throughout the day rummaging through folders to find my work. Everything I do is written on this one page. I like to think of the daily document as the single workspace that gets everything done. It's a combination of my to-do list and inbox, scratch paper, calendar, basically any message or query or even creative idea or light bulb moment that randomly hits me throughout the day will all be written down on my daily doc for convenience and to keep my work in flow. Then at the end of the day, I can go through and sort out my notes and then link them to their appropriate places in my database. So let's create a new daily doc. You can find the button at the top right here, or you can use Alt-D or Option-D. So earlier today, after I woke up, I did a little bit of journaling as part of my morning routine, just getting down some thoughts, some goals, and some tasks that I want to get done. So for today, I need to start writing my psychology essay. I have a Zoom call at 11 with John, a new business partner, and I have some grocery shopping due later. So let's tackle the first task, which is to start writing my essay for psychology class. I'm gonna create my project just right here in the daily doc, right underneath my journaling. And pretty much everything I do for today will just be on this page. Makes it nice and convenient and keeps me on task. So for this project, let's add some info so that I can discover it later. And I've already made a template a long time ago, so I'm gonna go ahead and bring that in and use that. So remember, everything I nest under this note is going to be part of that page. See? So remember how emojis in RemNote are all references? Well, I like to mark all my due dates with this date emoji. If I click on this emoji, it'll take me to that page and I can see all the projects I have and their due dates. See? And same goes for project status. I mark all my project status with the sun emoji so that I can see which projects are currently active, which ones I've already completed, and which ones I have on pause. And these are all categories that I've designed myself because that's how I like to think about information. So you can pick to organize your tasks however you like. So I'm typing and working on my essay project, and suddenly I get a call from one of my coworkers saying that I have some papers to sign before next Friday. So I'm gonna just write that down up here, sign papers for work by exclamation next Friday. And notice that I just typed out the words next Friday and RemNote understood exactly what I was doing. And notice how I didn't have to leave this daily doc and dig through other folders to do anything. I can just jot down random stuff throughout the day and still be able to work on my essay. All right, so I've been working on my essay for a good bit and now it's 11 o'clock. So I'm gonna hop on a Zoom call with John. Okay, so John seems like a pretty cool guy. During our conversation, he recommended the book, The 4-Hour Workweek by Tim Ferriss. Sounds like a pretty good book, so I might wanna check it out later. I'm gonna just make a quick note of that right here. And nested under that, I can write recommended by John. If I end up enjoying the book, I can always call him up and thank him for the recommendation and we can have a conversation about it. But I'm gonna tag it with to read. This is how I add books to my reading list using RemNote. See, I can hop in here real quick and you can see that I have a couple other book recommendations on my reading list. Also during our conversation, we talked about a product launch on Kickstarter. And I don't really know much about how to be successful on Kickstarter, so I'm gonna write that down here and tag it with to research so that I can look into that later. So overall, I'm really glad that I got to connect with John. He's gonna be one of our business partners, and so I want to remember information about him. So what I'll do is I'll make a page just for him and I'll fill out this template so that I can remember his info. And this is a quick and easy way to keep a contact list of all the important people in your life. The next time I hop on a Zoom call with John, I can quickly refer to this and remind myself where he's from or what sports teams he follows, or any gesture or attention to detail that could make the difference in our working partnership. Notice how I use the tag people over here on the right, so if I ever want to see my full contact list, I can go there to check it out. So now it's the end of the day, and it's time for me to review and sort out my notes. Some people like to do this at the end of the day, some people like to do this at the end of the week as a weekly review, but it's quite simple. I'll go through and tag my notes to their specific places in my database using either references or tags. I still need to sign these work papers, but maybe I can tackle that tomorrow, so I'll use Command-Shift-M to move this to-do to tomorrow's date. My friend sent me this article, so I'll put that on my reading list. And let's make sure to make today's daily journal a reference so that today's entry shows up in my daily journal page. And basically, I'm just going through and tidying things up so that whenever I stumble upon these notes again in the future, I'll know when these notes were created based on which daily doc they were originally written in.
And that's it. If you want to see how I use Smart Notes to write an essay from start to finish, or how I study in medical school, then check out these videos over here, and the full playlist can be found here. Thanks for watching.